Hello everyone, myself Prashant Patil. Today we will see a new topic, deadlock avoidance of subject operating system. Deadlock prevention algorithm is discussed. Already discussed, prevent deadlock for restricting how requests can be made. The restraints ensure that at least one of the necessary conditions for deadlock cannot occur and hence that deadlock cannot hold. Possible side effect of preventing deadlock by this method, however, are low device utilization and reduced system throughput. The next slide is prevent deadlock. Prevent deadlock by restricting how requests can be made. The restraints ensure that at least one of the necessary conditions for the deadlock cannot occur and hence that deadlock cannot hold. An alternate method for avoiding deadlock is to require additional information about how resources are to be requested. For example, in a system with one tape drive and one printer, a system might need to know that process P will request first the tape drive and then printer before releasing both resources, whereas process Q will request first the printer and then the tape drive. With this knowledge of the complete sequence of requests and release for each processes, the system can decide for each request whether or not the process should wait in order to avoid a possible future deadlock. Each request requires that in making this decision, the system consider the resources. Currently available, the resources currently allocated to each process and the future requests and releases of each processes. The various algorithms that use this approach differ in the amount and type of information required. The simplest and the most useful model requires that each process declare that maximum number of resources of each type that it may be need. Given this prior information of resource each type of that may be need, it is possible to construct an algorithm that ensure that system will never enter a deadlock state. Such an algorithm defines the deadlock avoidance approach. A deadlock avoidance algorithm dynamically examines, means to check, the resource allocation state to ensure that a circular wait condition can never exist. A resource allocation state is defined by the number of available and allocated resources and the maximum demands of the process. In this following section, we explore two deadlock avoidance algorithms. The first one is the deadlock avoidance algorithm. The first one is the safe state. A state is safe if system can allocate resource to each process in some order and still avoid a deadlock. More formally, a system is in a safe state only if there exists a safe sequence. A sequence of processes starting from P1 up P2, P3 up to P of n is a safe sequence for the current allocation state. For each P of I, the resource request that P of I can still make can be satisfied by the currently available resources plus the resource held by all P of j, with j is less than I. In this situation, if the resources that P of I needs are not immediately available, then P of I can wait until all P of j have finished. When they have finished, P of I can obtain all its needed resources, complete its decision task, returns its allocated resources and terminate. When P of I terminates, P of I plus 1 can obtain its needed resources, and so on. If no such sequence exists, then the system state is said to be a unsafe, which is called as unsafe state. A safe state is not a deadlocked state. A deadlocked state is unsafe state. Not all unsafe states are deadlocks. See in the figure. An unsafe state may lead to a deadlock. As long as the state is safe, the operating system can avoid unsafe states. In an unsafe state, operating system cannot prevent the processes from requesting resources in such a way that a deadlock occurs. The behavior of the process controls unsafe states. We consider a system with 12 magnetic tape drives and 3 processes P0, P1 and P2. These are the 3 different processes. Process 0 requires 10 tape drives. Process P1 may need as many as 4 tape drives. And process P2 may need up to 9 tape drives. Suppose that at time T0, process P0 is holding 5 tape drives, process P1 is holding 2 tape drives, and process P2 holding 2 tape drives. See in the table, at system in a safe state, a sequence P0, P1, P0 and P2 satisfies the safety condition. Process P(I) can immediately be allocated to its tape drives and then returns them. The process P0 can get all its tape drives and return them. And finally, process P2 can get all its tape drives and return them. A system can go from a safe state to an unsafe state. Suppose that a time T1 process P2 request and is allocated one more tape drive. The system is no longer in safe state. At this point, only process P1 can be allocated all its tape drives. When it returns them, the system will have only 4 available tape drives. Since process P0 is allocated 5 tape drives but has a maximum of 10, it may request 5 more tape drives. If it does so, it will have to wait because they are unavailable. Similarly, the process P2 may request 6 additional tape drives and have to wait, resulting in a deadlock. Our mistake was in granting the request from process P2 for one more tape drive. If we had made P2 wait until either of the other processes had finished and released its resources, then we would have avoided the deadlock. A system can go from a safe state to an unsafe state. Suppose that time T1 process P2 request and is allocated one more tape drive. Likewise, all the processes are continuously in working. The given concept of safe state, we can define avoidance algorithm that ensure that the system will never deadlock. The idea is simply to ensure that the system will always remain in a safe state. Initially, the system is in safe state whenever a process requests a resource that is currently available. The system must decide whether the resource can be allocated immediately or whether the process must wait. The request is granted only if the allocation leaves the system in a safe state. In this schema, if a process requests a resource that is currently available, it may still have to wait. Thus, resource utilizations may be lower than it would otherwise be. Thank you.